Welcome friends. Today we will be discussing on shape functions or linear interpolation functions for solid elements, that is tetrahedron and hexahedron elements. This figure shows a linear tetrahedron element. Tetrahedron in the sense it is a primary solid element. Figure shows a tetrahedron element in global coordinate system, that is XYZ coordinate system. It is having four nodes, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and at each node 3 degrees of freedom, that is X, Y and Z displacements. It is having four triangular faces, hence it is called as a tetrahedron. Tetra means four, hedra means faces, hence it is called as a tetrahedron. To obtain the shape functions in terms of natural coordinates, let us consider a master tetrahedron element in natural coordinates. These natural coordinates are z, eta and zeta are the three natural coordinates perpendicular axis perpendicular to each other. The values of the natural coordinates at different nodes has been shown in the master element in the figure. Referring to the figure, the values of natural coordinates at four nodes are: at node 1 you can see that z is equal to 1, eta is equal to 0 and zeta is equal to 0. At node 2 z is equal to 0, eta is equal to 1 and zeta is equal to 0. At node 3 z is equal to 0, eta is equal to 0 and zeta is equal to 1. At node 4, all 3 are 0. To find the shape function n1, that is shape function at node 1, as it is a linear tetrahedron element, hence the variation of displacement as well as the variation of shape functions will be linear in nature. Hence, let us assume a linear interpolation polynomial in terms of natural coordinates as n1 is equal to a0 plus a1 into zeta plus a1 into z plus a2 into eta plus a3 into zeta. Let us call this as equation 1. At node 1, that is when z is equal to 1, eta equal to 0 and zeta is equal to 0, we know that the value of shape function n1 is equal to 1. This is from the properties of the shape function, that the value of shape function will be equal to 1 at its own node and it will be equal to 0 at the other nodes. Now substituting these in equation 1, we get 1 is equal to a0 plus a1. Let us call this as equation A. Now at node 2, that is at z is equal to 0, eta equal to 1 and zeta equal to 0, from figure we know that shape function n1 is equal to 0 at node 2, and substituting these in equation 1, we get 0 is equal to a0 plus a2. Let us call this as say equation B. Now at node 3, that is when z equal to 0, eta equal to 0 and zeta equal to 1, we know that shape function n1 is equal to 0. And substituting these in equation 1, we get 0 is equal to a0 plus a3. Now at node 4, that is when z equal to zeta equal to and eta equal to 0, n1 is equal to 0. Now substituting this in equation 1, we get a0 is equal to 0. Now substituting the value of this a0 from equation, let us call this as equation D. Now substituting the value of this a0 from equation D into equation A, B and C, we get a1 is equal to 1, a2 is equal to 0 and a3 is equal to 0. Now substituting these values of a0, a1, a2 and a3 in equation 1, we get n1 is equal to zeta. We can take linear polynomial for n2 And by using the property of the shape function that n2 is equal to 1 at node 2 and equal to 0 at nodes 1, 3 and 4, we will get n2 is equal to eta. N1 is equal to z we have got, n2 is equal to eta. Similarly, if we take a linear polynomial for n3 and substitute the properties of shape function that n3 is equal to 1 at node 3 and equal to 0 at other nodes, that is 1, 2 and 4, we will be getting n3 is equal to zeta. Now we know that n1 is equal to z, n2 is equal to eta and n3 is equal to zeta. And we also know that the property of the shape, one more property of the shape function, that the sum of shape functions is always equal to unity. That is n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus n4 is equal to 1. Hence, from that property, n4 is equal to 1 minus of n1 minus of n2 minus of n3. Hence, n1 is equal to 1 minus z minus eta minus zeta. Hence, these are the four shape functions for a linear tetrahedron element that are given by n1 is equal to z, n2 is equal to eta, n3 is equal to zeta and n4 is equal to 1 minus z minus eta minus zeta. Now let us consider, derive the shape functions for a linear hexahedron element. A hexahedron element in the sense, hexa means 6, hedra means faces. So it will have 6 quadrilateral faces. And this figure shows a master hexahedron element in natural coordinate systems, that is z, eta and zeta. It has 8 nodes. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. And at each node, there will be 3 degrees of freedom, that is x, y and z displacements. The values of the natural coordinates at different nodes are shown in this master element figure for hexahedron element. To obtain the shape functions in terms of natural coordinates, let us consider the master element in natural coordinates as shown in this figure. On the master cube, the Lagrange shape functions can be written as, the general expression for Lagrange shape function for a master cube is written as ni is equal to 1 by 8 into bracket 1 plus z zi into 1 plus eta eta I into 1 plus zeta zeta I. I is equal to 1 to 8, where I is the node number. So shape function at node 1, that is at I is equal to 1, n1 is equal to, from above figure we know the value of z, eta and zeta at node 1 as minus 1, minus 1 and minus 1. And substituting these in equation 1, we get n1 is equal to 1 by 8 into bracket 1 minus zeta into 1 minus, 1 minus z into 1 minus eta into 1 minus zeta. Now the shape function at node 2, that is at I is equal to 2, then n2, from the above figure, when at node 2, that is when z is equal to 1, eta is equal to minus 1 and zeta equal to minus 1, substituting these values in equation 1, we get n2 is equal to 1 by 8 into bracket 1 plus z, 1 minus eta, 1 minus zeta. Similarly, shape function at node 3 can be written as, that is when I is equal to 3. At node 3, we know that z equal to 1, eta equal to 1 and zeta equal to minus 1. Substituting, we get, substituting in equation 1, we get n3 is equal to 1 by 8 into bracket 1 plus z, 1 plus eta into 1 minus zeta. Similarly, we can find n4, that is shape function at node 4, when z equal to minus 1, eta equal to 1 and zeta equal to minus 1, we'll get n4 equal to 1 by 8 into bracket 1 minus z into 1 minus eta into 1 minus zeta. Similarly, you can find n phi as 1 by 8 into bracket 1 minus z 1 minus eta into 1 plus zeta. Similarly, at shape function at node 6, that is shape function n6 can be given as n6 equal to 1 by 8 into bracket 1 plus z 1 minus eta into 1 plus zeta. Similarly, shape function at node 7, that is when I is equal to 7, n7 is 1 by 8 into bracket 1 plus zeta, 1 plus z, 1 plus eta and 1 plus zeta. Because at 7, z equal to 1, eta equal to 1 and zeta equal to 1. Then at node 8, that is when z equal to minus 1, eta equal to 1 and zeta equal to 1, n8 will become 1 by 8 into bracket 1 minus zeta, 1 minus z, 1 plus eta into 1 plus zeta. Hence, these are the eight shape functions for a hexalinear hexahedron element as shown in figure. Thank you very much.